President Trump asked me to speak to this convention in the name of unity.
We need a commander-in-chief who can lead 24 hours a day and 7 days a week. America cannot afford 4 more years of a Weekend at Bernie's presidency.
Donald Trump has my strong endorsement, period.
It is the values of this Republican Party that reflect our nation's founding principles. We believe schools should educate, not indoctrinate. We stand for parents' rights, including universal school choice.
We should acknowledge that there are some Americans who don't agree with Donald Trump 100% of the time. I happen to know some of them.
We support law and order, not rioting and disorder. We seek a strong, focused United States military, not one distracted by a social agenda. We reject entrenched political class, and we demand term limits for members of Congress.
You don't have to agree with Trump 100% of the time to vote for him. Take it from me, I haven't always agreed with President Trump. But we agree more often than we disagree.
We stand for fiscal sanity, for low taxes, and for reduced debt. We seek to reclaim the constitutional government as envisioned by our founding fathers by bringing the administrative state to heel once and for all.
We agree on keeping America strong. We agree on keeping America safe.
We believe that you must be a citizen in order to vote, and that photo ID should be required before casting a ballot.
And we agree that Democrats have moved so far to the left that they're putting our freedoms in danger.
We stand for strong borders and believe that our nation must have a shared civic culture. And we oppose any immigration that stands apart or in contrast to our American values.
I'm here tonight because we have a country to save. And a unified Republican Party is essential for saving her.
We believe in the principles articulated in the Declaration of Independence that our rights come not from the generosity of the state, but from the hand of the Almighty, including the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
To my fellow Republicans, we must not only be a unified party, we must also expand our party.
We have a responsibility to preserve what George Washington called the sacred fire of liberty. This was a fire that burned in Independence Hall in 1776 when 56 men pledged their lives, their fortunes, and their sacred honor to establish this nation.
We are so much better when we are bigger.
It's a fire that burned at a cemetery in Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, when our nation's first Republican president pledge this nation to a new birth of freedom.
We are stronger when we welcome people into our party who have different backgrounds and experiences.
It's a fire that burned at the foot of the Berlin Wall in 1987 when our nation's 40th president stood in front of that wall and said, "Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall."
And right now, we need to be strong to save America.
This is not a responsibility we should fear. It's a responsibility we should welcome. After all, if not us, who? And if not now, when?
No president can fix all of our problems alone. We have to do this together. America has an amazing ability to self-correct. In this moment, we have a chance to put aside our differences and focus on what unites us and strengthens our country.
Let's make the 45th president of the United States the 47th president of the United States.
Let us join together as a party. Let us come together as a people, as one country, strong and proud. Let us show our children and the world that even on our worst day, we are blessed to live in America.
Let's elect Republicans up and down the ballot, and let's heed the call of our party's nominee to fight, fight, fight for these United States. Thank you.
God bless you. Thank you. God bless the United States of America.
God bless you. Let's win in November. Thank you so much.